हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज समर्पण ज्ञान स्कूल, क्लास 9, मैथमेटिक्स, लेसन नंबर 6, लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। जस्ट वी इंट्रोड्यूस अबाउट द लाइंस एंड द एंगल्स विच यू स्टडीड फ्रॉम द क्लास 5 टिल टुडे। सी द बेसिक टर्म्स एंड डेफिनेशन। ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक एंड सी ऑन पेज नंबर 90 व्हाट आर द बेसिक टर्म्स एंड द डेफिनेशन यू मस्ट नो before you start actual study of the class 9. See what the basic terms are there. First is the line segment. What is the line segment? A part of a line with two endpoints is called a line segment. Means it is the part of line. It is a part of line with two endpoints is called. See, this is a line. If this is line, then for this line we use the two arrows at end, two arrows at its ends. Now see your definition. What definition telling to you? A part of a line. Suppose this is the part of a line. Okay, part of a line with two endpoints. This and these are the two endpoints. This part is known as line segment. This part is known as line segment. And this whole structure is line. See once again. A part. This is a line. Part of a line with two endpoints is known as a line segment. Means very big is the line. And part of that big is the line segment. Clear to you? Next, it is denoted by, the segment is denoted by AB dash. Okay? And its length is denoted by AB. Means only length if you are giving, then you simply write AB. And if you are to write the segment, segment AB, then AB bar will be there. Instead of bar, you can use the symbols. Now suppose you have to use the ray. What is the ray now? This part. See, this and this. What is the difference here? This is going to the right side and this is going to the left side. Means if one point and one arrow is given either to any side, then this is known as ray. Okay? Now ray is denoted by AB. See here. AB and arrow is put there. Second is AB. Okay, AB is the line. If it is the line, then symbol is line AB. If it is ray, then ray AB. And if it is the segment, then simply bar is there. Got it? These are the basic terms which we have to use related to line. Now we see about the points. If three or more points lie on the same line, suppose this is a line. On this line, these are the different points. Three or more than three. Then these all points lies on one line. They are known as collinear. Collinear points. Means if all points lie on one line, then that points known as collinear points. This definition given to you in your book. Otherwise, they are called non-collinear points. Otherwise means what? This is the line. Three points are here, one point is outside the line. As we extended line from both sides, that line cannot be touched to this point. Then these points are known as non-collinear. Non-collinear points. Collinear means on one line. Non-collinear means not on one point. On one line. Not on one line, non-collinear. Lie on one line, collinear. Recall now angles. What is the angle? Angle is formed when two rays originate from the same endpoint. See, the diagram. This is one ray, this is the other ray. and these two rays are originated started from one point, then such structure is known as the angle. And this is angle x, this is angle y, this is angle z. Here two rays are there and they are started from the same initial point, then such structure is known as the angle. Now types of angles. This is the acute angle. If the measure of angle between 0 to 90 degree, then angle is known as acute angle. If measure of angle is exactly 90 degree, then it is right angle. If measure of angle lies between 90 to 180, means more than 90 and less than 180, then it is obtuse angle. Definitions are given and diagrams also given. Now the next angle is straight angle, straight line. Two arrows are there, suppose from here, here or anywhere. You suppose this ray is bending like this, like this, like this, and it come exactly at the straight line, then that angle is known as a straight angle and its measure is 180 degree. And the next type is reflex angle. Reflex means what? Suppose you have the angle here and its measure is, suppose this angle measure is 30 degree, suppose. Then the whole measure is 360. Whole circle is measure 360. 360 minus 30 will be the reflex angle of 30. Means its measure lies between 180 to 360. More than 180 but less than 360 is known as the reflex angle. Okay. Now, once again revise. Acute angle lies between 0 to 90. Right angle measure is 90 degree. Angle greater than 90 degree but less than 180 is called obtuse angle. Angle of the measure 180 degree is called a straight angle. And the angle measure greater than 180 but less than 360 is known as the reflex angle. Now next part is the complementary angles. If sum of the two angles is 90 degree, then they are complementary. And sum of the two angles is 180, then it is supplementary angle. Suppose you have given two angles, x plus y equal to 90 degree, then x and y are complementary. If A and B are two angles, their addition is 180, then A and B are supplementary angles. Means if addition is 180 degree, then they are supplementary. If addition is 90 degree, then they are complementary angles. Okay. See next part, adjacent angle. See the figure now. These are the two angles. Actually, they are the three angles. This is the big one. A, B, C is the largest. Then A, B, D and C, B, D. These are the two. Means the larger angle A, B, C is divided into two angles due to the ray B, D. Now we focus on the ray B, D. We have the two angles, this one and this one. If you see that this part, interior of this angle and interior of this angle are disjoint. Nothing is common in these two parts. And one arm, one ray is common in these two angles. Then these two angles known as adjoint angles. Adjoint angle have the definition what? One ray is common and interiors are different. Initial point must be the same. And addition of these two angles ABD plus CBD is equal to ABC. Okay. Next part is the linear pair of angles. What is the definition of linear pair of angles? If addition of these two is 180. Okay. Then it is linear pair. Means like supplementary. Plus if two parts, interior parts of two angles, interior of two angles are different. One arm is common and non-common arm means arm BA and arm BC. Non-common arm should be in straight line. means BA and BC are in one straight line. This is the common ray and interiors are different. Then that structure is known as linear pair of angles. See here also the non-common arms are here. These and these are non-common arms. But they are not in straight line. There they are. Therefore they are adjacent angles, not linear pair angles. Clear? Next is the vertically opposite angle. What is the meaning of vertically? You simply remember the capital letter X in the English alphabets. When English alphabet X, letter X is there, then we are getting the four angle. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four angles are there. Out of these four angles, these four angles are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Out of these four angles, this angle is, interior of this angle is upward, interior of this angle is downward. Then they are exactly opposite to each other. Similarly, for the angle 2 and 4, angle 2's interior is to the right side, interior of angle 4 is to the left side. Therefore, right and left are opposite to each other. Therefore, we are getting the two pairs of vertically opposite angles, pair 1 and 3, and second pair is 2 and 4. Means what? When two lines crosses to each other, then we are getting the two pairs of vertically opposite angle, 1 and 3, 2 and 4. Got it? Next part, intersecting lines and non-intersecting lines. See, suppose you are given the two lines, then either they are parallel to each other or they are not parallel to each other, means they are intersecting lines. If two lines are parallel, then they are non-intersecting. And if two lines are not parallel, they are intersecting lines. These are the different structure of the lines. Now next is the pair of angles. First is linear pair of angles, as we discussed just now. Linear pair of angles. This is the addition of two angles is 180 degree. Then these angles are known as linear pair of angles. In this way, today we see the line, ray, line segment, angles, types of angles and pair of angles. In a homework, you have to draw the diagrams, write the definitions with the help of the textbooks and this video. In the next part, we see the data related to the exercise 6.1 and we proceed further. Till then, thank you. Stay at home. Be healthy. Thank you.